It's me again, the Latin guru, Charo Diaz. It's been a while since we had a little chat, and today I'm here with Sam. After a few months, we came back from
our journeys.
Yes, the New Year's. And I'm here just having a little talk about life, family, and relationships. And for those who have siblings, I was just saying that, I mean, you go through experience, you gain knowledge, and in life you mustn't become a bully. A bully to, especially to those that are close to you. Because most probably, I'm talking from my own experiences, my own mistakes, that obviously I regret.
Can you explain shortly, what do you mean by don't become a bully to your close ones?
Yes, so basically, like, if you, I mean, if you're a... I was saying that sometimes guys, men, have an attitude towards females that I feel we definitely need to change. Because what we reflect with other people, what happens with other people on the street is more or less a reflection that of what you do in the house. And if you have brothers and sisters, and I feel that what you gain, the knowledge that you gain, the experience that you go through, you should use them. This is my personal belief. You should use them to help them rather than creating a worse environment at your house. You should use it to be of support, because that's what you have. You have your siblings and your parents, and then obviously you going and causing a struggle within their environment and disturbing that environment is not going to help you, and it's not going to help them. Yes, and that's part of our growth, and that's part of our...
What do you mean by disturbing their environment? Can you say
so? Basically, I feel that men, some men who do PUA, pickup artists, the way they behave outside with the girls. This is about the personal attitude. Yes,
in general.
If you're an asshole, do you have to be an asshole at your house? Yes, I think it's just wrong. Many people could disagree with this, but I think it's just so wrong that you're gonna go and bully your sisters. Yes, and do whatever you do in the streets. Yes, and then you give your sisters a life of hell. And this is what you need to change. Yes, I learned not to get people upset. What you learn has to be of use. Yes, I feel that PUA is meant to help you. It helps you in the sense of you grow and you can help others grow. And it doesn't have to be only you don't have to be a leader of men. You can be a leader of women.
I think that's very that's important and interesting. And you have to be a good leader.
Yes, that's the...
To guide them, isn't it?
To guide. Yes.
And
all the bad experience that you've been through, if you've been bullied by your dad, your mom, your brothers, it comes to the point that you just have to do a 360 degrees turn in your life, and you just have to say, stop, we've got to stop this. And you just have to change your philosophy, because that's the hardest things. Change and adapt to new philosophies if you want to grow.
Can you give a short example of how to change and adapt in real life situation? Like everyday life situation. Something you have experienced or something, so we have a better understanding.
I just think that I was telling.
Well,
Sam,
you were telling
that,
me. Yeah, yeah.
That do I believe you can learn to love someone? I think with time, you can. You see the qualities of a person when you start sharing with them. Yes. Sometimes the first few moments for some people is the honeymoon. Yes, the honeymoon moment, and it only lasts for a short time.
Yeah.
But in other occasions, it could be the opposite. It starts, it could start also bad, also wrong. and it could happen to be the right situation.
Wow, that's an amazing experience. Go on.
That's my personal experience, my personal belief, and that's what has happened to me. All I'm doing is just sharing you my opinions, sharing you my experiences, and this is what I see, and this is why I was recommending him. I know Sam has been through bad situations with his family. They're gone from living on one place and adapting to a new place, and the family breaking apart. And so just look at life as you having a second chance. It's like you can create a new version of yourself, a new improved version. And this is the chance. This is the chance. What I'm saying is don't keep saying being the same. Being something new, be something amazing. And especially be amazing to those close to you.
Yeah.
Why to be an asshole to those ones close to you? Because it's just disappointing. And I said to him, it's just a waste of energy.
So I have a question. If we understand that, what if someone is someone you care about is being an asshole to you? How do you react in that situation? What would you do?
Yeah.
Can you give an explanation on that? Because that's very interesting.
I just feel that I always get the benefit of the doubt to people, as I said to him. But I believe that they're angels, who within are hiding a devil. Yes, and some people can come across as being nice, and yes, and I do believe we can have it. We all have it. But it's when we realize that we're doing something wrong, and we decide to change and do all the opposite. That's a good thing, but some people don't change. So why? This is when it comes to relationships. It could be with your parents, with your partner, siblings. If you have someone who is not good to you, and many of us give them the opportunity to change, but if they're not changing,
they're hurting you. They're making you feel bad.
Exactly. And it becomes so traumatic to the point
that it affects everyday life.
Affects your life, affects your study, your work,
everything.
It's times where
a lot of people start smoking, drinking, abuse, alcohol abuse.
And they become abusive to their children as well. Also you decide you want to stay with your partners or parents, even though they're abusive to you. And it comes to the point where you just have to say enough is enough. This has to end, and that's it. You just have to move on. It can be very painful and stressful
to leave
that all behind. But maybe the grass is greener
on the other side.
On the other side.
Perfect, man. Wow.
That's about.
No, you said something earlier about war, like, you know, when
I said sometimes when it comes to relationships, and you decide to stick on the little things, and I know we all go through, if you're thinking of if you decide to hold things against someone for a very long time, for very tiny things, and you think I'm gonna hold back this, hold on to this for a long time. And what happened is that it's those little things that you don't want to let go, the ones that affect a perfect situation, a perfect relationship. So sometimes you just have to forget it and just move on. Just move on, think, move on and pursue your bigger dreams. Pursue those dreams that are gonna bring you benefit, because the main person that has to benefit is, that you got to benefit is yourself. Yes, don't think about your partner, don't think about your kids, think about yourself. If you decide to, I try not to get distracted by relationships. I just forget about relationships, but concentrate and focus on yourself.
Growing as a man.
Yes, and growing as a man or as a woman. Just ignore everything, forget about relationships. Ignore the losers, ignore the no believers, ignore the abusers, leave them, go away, move away. And in order that you can have that space for you to grow and know and don't get stuck in situations that are just gonna get you distracted and as I said to you, if you
harm
have,
you,
if you
it's
have
not
your,
good
if,
for
yes,
you.
If you have your girlfriend, by experience, it will just distract you and it's gonna affect her. And also, if you're gonna be thinking, or someone else is gonna be banging her, because probably someone else is banging her.
It's reality.
It's a reality. Yes, girls tend to find create faster relationships than men do.
Which is a fact. Of course,
it's a fact of life. And if we can understand all these things, yes, and you can get detached from relationships and more attached to yourself, to your self-development, then I feel you're in the right track. Yes, because if you benefit, if you grow, you can benefit your friends, your close friends, and your family, and your relatives. If that's what you want.
Makes sense. Yeah.
Yes, but if you
you're
just allow yourself
to
get distracted by what things that happened in the past. Yes, by your relationships, by things that go on in life and all your bad situations and all your bad experience, then that's
earlier.
Not going to help you. Yes, earlier. So you just have to come to the present and look with to the future with a fresh mind, clear mind, thinking that, we all make mistakes. It's part of life. Life is can be shit, but it can also, I call it, bad situations can create perfect opportunities.
Wow.
And it's only how you see the war. And at the moment, that's where I was telling him, I have quite a few ideas, quite a few dreams that I need to concentrate on. And I don't need no relationship, no nothing to distract me. When I know what I'm planning to do could even save lives. Yes. So but that would be part of the next.
And the last question would be, how do you, for yourself personally, how did you manage, what is your daily mentality for the person you are today? Because I've seen you like this for years, since I know you. You've had this type of mentality. How did you develop? Because now I see you, you're actually able to communicate what you are.
No, I think since we started making the videos.
Yeah. You're very confident.
I've become more confident.
About expressing yourself and who you are.
Before,
so how did you manage it? What's your mindset? We want to know.
I just think that I commit myself so much to the goals, the purpose that come through my life, that I just don't have no more time to get distracted.
Oh, wow.
That's
amazing.
That's the finish, because those goals, the bigger dreams, the bigger goals, become so demanding that all my energy, all my focus, it just tunnels me. And every day, I'm just tunneled to that main tunnel.
Purpose.
That main purpose that is driving me towards that goal. It's only a dream, but that's.
Wow.
That's how I live. I live off dreams that eventually are going
Amazing.
To become realities, and it's just my mind mentality is just focused, tunneled towards that target, and nothing else gets past or nothing gets through. Yes, and I don't let them. And
okay,
that's how it is.
Two short questions before we finish. I'm sure as a human being, as a man, is there any days you wake up and you feel like just giving up and
Yes, lots of times. I made one of the videos.
Really?
And actually,
can you tell us a little bit about that?
Yes,
and recommend the video so people will watch.
There is a video where you see me in central London, and I met this chick. I was going towards the gym. She was depressed. She was drinking, and she just said she wanted company. Yes. I was a bit unsure of what to do,
but then
I decided, okay, let's go, and let's go. Maybe changing. I was feeling depressed. I was actually going because I was feeling the most depressed at that time.
You as well.
I mean,
both of you were feeling depressed. Wow.
So, but the thing is that we went to Central London, and what she offered me, drugs. Yes.
What did she offer you?
Amphetamines.
Oh my goodness. So what did you do?
No, I just said that I wasn't drinking, I was not smoking, I was not interested in that. And just short version, she was feeling guilty because in their back home where they're from, there were her and the brother. The brother died in a fire.
Oof.
And the dad always wanted a son. When the son died, he blamed the daughter.
Mm.
Not because she caused the fire, but because that son, that wanted son was gone.
Mm.
So he took it on her and he used to beat her up and all these things. And to the point, she just have to leave the house and come to London. And she ended up in a relationship with an abusive partner. So many things, yes.
So she's in pain.
So she was in pain all the time. And she felt that no one listened to her, no one cared. But I just couldn't, I couldn't feel taken advantage of that situation. I also felt that I could give advice, yes.
Mm-hmm.
But you can only give advice, and by experience I learned, don't get involved. Yes, because it is your choice. You either smoke, quit smoking, don't drink, don't do drugs, and be healthier, have more money as well, and look for solutions. Yes, if your solution is that you need to get better in life, get a better job, then obviously you need to do something, study something, or develop some new skill.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, at the moment I feel that. And what is going to make a difference in my life is innovation.
Okay.
Yes, one good idea that is going to make me a fortune.
One thing, I think you're running out of topic, but the thing is, I'm going to bring you back to the topic because I'm really interested in you to finish the story. You're saying you're feeling depressed. So how, what happened, like how you felt, and you know, the question was, you said yes to there are days of you waking up, you feel like shit, you just want to give up. So how do you deal with it? Like, especially that day you give an example, how did you deal with it? You're feeling depression.
Yes,
how do you
yes.
get rid of it?
So basically for me, the way I get rid of the depression is basically having good rest. Because we sometimes, what happened during the week, I was just working, not having proper sleep, maybe having issues at my workplace.
Okay.
Having issues with my relationships.
Yeah.
And so when you get everything together, no proper rest and problems, every environment that you can change of, there is always problems. So, and if you're not rested, then it can overwhelm you and you just want to run away from it. Yes. So first thing I would say is rest properly.
Mm.
Second, don't give yourself headaches with relationships.
Mm-hmm.
Third, quit drugs, smoking,
mm-hmm.
alcohol,
mm.
and get yourself into doing exercises. Mm-hmm. And also,
exercises.
Yes.
Yeah?
Also, what I said, don't. I didn't want to get involved too much into this girl's depression because she's been having it for a long time,
mm-hmm.
and I feel that. It's good to help and good to give advice, but when you decide to get into something and the person don't, this is the thing, you don't want to change, you don't want to adapt, yes? And you know, you tried, but that person don't want to understand,
mm-hmm.
then sometimes it's the same thing when it comes to abusive relationships.
Yeah.
It's best to get away with it.
Run away.
Yes,
build.
Running doesn't make you a coward. Yes, running away.
Sometimes
from,
you have to survive.
To survive. Yes,
I agree.
Yes.
I've been a personal victim and experienced that.
Yes.
Okay, I understand. So, what's your star sign? Horoscope.
Pisces.
Mm. Which month you're born in?
March.
Okay, actually, I'll tell you that later. Okay, Pisces, March. Okay. What else? So. Just last point, because we're gonna make it 20 minutes. It's exactly 18 minutes 53 seconds.
Mm-hmm.
You have one minute 10 seconds more. You said don't get involved in relationships,
mm-hmm.
and don't make it your headache.
Yes.
So, what, as a man, I believe that sometimes
you have to
deal with relationships.
Yes, yes,
but
yes.
What did you mean, to run away from it, or
no? It just depends on the situation. When things get very bad.
Mm-hmm.
To the point there is no fixing.
Yeah.
Yes, just move away.
Okay.
Yeah. Other things.
Because you're saying that, because every one of us human beings, we can feel that, oh, this is over. There is no fixing.
Mm.
So instead of trying to fix it,
just
move forward.
Just move forward.
That's what you mean,
yes,
yeah?
Yes.
I get it. And what did you want to say? You can finish it up.
Also, if there are things that don't need to be fixed, why to fix it? Yes. Why do you bother about things that don't need to be fixed? Yes, if you have a good relationship, and is not there no issues or anything, why do you have to do something to change it? Just because you just decided to change it. Basically, yeah, that's
amazing, man. Thank you so much. That was 20 minutes. Exactly. Anything else you wanna say?
No, that's all.
Okay, man. Thank you very much for your time, your energy, and you know, your wise words, man. I'm sure this will, yeah, look at his muscle, he goes to the gym, it will help me. This video is especially for me because you're a personal friend and I needed advice like this, especially in this time of my life. And there will be a day I'll probably show a lot of people that, look, you know, this guy amazing, we've been friends, and you know, he's a very wise person, he's very knowledgeable. So thank you very much.
Mistakes, we made it all, and I made so many, so
No one is perfect. He's not perfect. I'm not perfect.
And I'm not claiming to be the perfect person. Just nothing like that. I'm just saying, just make mistakes. You make mistakes, move on, and just trying to learn from it. It's a mistake not to learn. That's the mistake, not to learn from the mistakes.
Yeah, amazing. Thank you very much, man.